Hey y'all, and welcome back. I'm Nikki, and we have something so delicious today. It is Bahamian boiled fish. Very simple ingredients, and I'm going to show you just how to do it. So that's all you need: your lime, potatoes, onion, pepper, and salt. So we're going to be doing the boiled fish with grouper. I know it sounds expensive, and it is expensive. So I just added some salt to water because grouper, being saltwater fish, it's in its natural environment for me to clean it. So I'm just going to go over and make sure that I remove any additional stuff. You know, if you're going to get it from the fish house or from a fisherman or whatever, you want to clean your fish just like you would your meat. And it is imperative. So I'm just showing you exactly how it is. I did not go through the process because I just didn't want to offend or disturb anybody by being so graphic with the fish. So what I'm doing is just taking the knife and just going over the pieces to make sure that all the scales are off, because you just want to make sure you're not consuming scales from your fish. That's not edible. That's not what we do. So I'm just gonna go over it, and if you see there, you see how it's looking, and making sure that I do it carefully so that I get all the scales and any additional debris off of the fish. And we're just going to do this for each piece. And it is, you just want to do it. And right here, you see, those are scales from the fish. And of course, I'm just going to go over it and make sure that that isn't something that will end up in my good pot of boiled fish. See, you see all those scales? That's not what you want. That's not cute. Not at all. So you want to just make sure that you go over your fish, clean it properly, and rinse it about 2 times to be exact. So after all of that, I went ahead and I drained the water, make sure it was clear, rinsed it again, and I'm just adding salt to the fish because I want to make sure that if there's any debris on the surface, that being any leftover scales that may not have rinsed off, that I get all of those and everything. So I'm just taking the pieces from the top, and then I'm going to go in and put some salt on the pieces of the grouper at the bottom of the strainer, and then just rinse them thoroughly again just to make sure that it is cleaned and cleaned properly. So there you see the salt going in there. So I'm going to let you know, you're going to see me sprinkle a lot of salt in it, but it's just a sprinkle. So I'm heavy-handed with the cleaning of the fish with the salt, but everything else is just sprinkling. I'm just going to rinse those off. So now they're rinsed, they've drained, and everything. And if you can see, those are some big pieces. And for me, I like to taste the lime in my boiled fish. Actually, most Bahamians, we like lime in anything seafood. So that citrus presence has to be there. And of course, you have to balance it out with your salt and your pepper. So I'm just going to go ahead and squeeze some fresh lime. And if you could use fresh lime, please do so. If you use lemon or bottled lime, it gives it a completely different taste altogether. And right there's your scotch bonnet. That packs a lot of heat. So I'm only going to be using half of this because I'm entertaining, so I know that my spice level is completely different from my guests who will be consuming this as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and add the pieces here and make sure that all of them have the same amount of lime and a sprinkling of salt and a little bit of the pepper. I didn't use any of the seeds. That's where all of the heat is. I was very cautious of that just to make sure that my guests would be able to enjoy it with just a little bit of spice. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and do the exact same thing. We're gonna go ahead and put in that salt and that lime and that pepper just to make sure it's seasoned. And I usually do this about 15-20 minutes prior to me going ahead and cook. So I put the lid on the container and I shook it up because I wanted everything to have that lime and pepper and salt marinating through it. And I say it was seasoned to the bone, honey. It was seasoned to the bone. So here's my Dutch pot, and in the Dutch pot I have my potatoes already cut up. And I know you're thinking, oh, those potatoes are cut big, but I like to see my potatoes cut big like that. Of course, that's a personal preference. If you want to cut them smaller, you can go ahead and you can do that. So I'm just going to go ahead and add the pieces to the pot. Now, rule of thumb when you're doing boiled fish is when your potatoes are done, your fish is done. All right, so that is what we're gonna do. So we have the fish seated on top of the potatoes, and then we're just gonna go in with onions. It looks a lot, but they were thinly sliced. And I'm just making sure that they are well covered in there. And I'm gonna go back in, yes, I know you're saying it, with some more lime and some salt, but I'm just adding just a little bit of water. I don't want to cover the fish in the water because I don't want too much of that broth, okay? I don't like too much broth, but then again, my guests will have more than sufficient broth when they are ready to have their boiled fish. So you can see there, it is halfway up on the fish, and if I needed to, I can just go back in with it. So I've added my pepper, the Scotch bonnet that you see me had earlier, and of course I use sea salt. That's all I use. I don't use any other kind of salt. So I'm just gonna go in and sprinkle in just a little bit of salt, just to make sure that, you know, everything is good. And just another squeeze of lime. So when you're doing souse and your stew, kung stew fish, boiled fish, all of that stuff, that ain't just no one or two limes. You gotta have plenty limes, honey. So we're just gonna go in and squeeze the lime on it. And then I'm just gonna put a lid on this and let it cook for about 25 minutes on the medium to low heat. And here it is, the potatoes are done, the fish is done. And when I tell you, this boiled fish, this hit the spot, it hit the spot. Like, comment, share, and subscribe.